Let's draw the Lewis structure for BF3. This is boron trifluoride. The first thing we do with Lewis structures, we find the total number of valence electrons for the molecule. Let's look at the periodic table. So boron, that's right here, group 13, sometimes called 3A, that has 3 valence electrons. Fluorine, that's in group 17, sometimes called 7A. These elements, they have 7 valence electrons. We have 3 fluorine atoms. So 3 plus 21, 24 total valence electrons for the BF3 Lewis structure. We'll put the least electronegative element in the center. Boron is the least electronegative. Fluorine's the most electronegative element on the periodic table. So we have our boron, and then we'll put 3 fluorine atoms around it. Next, we're going to put 2 electrons between the atoms to form the chemical bond. So now each of these has a bond. They're sharing 2 electrons, covalent bond. Now we can complete the octets on the atoms on the outside, the fluorine atoms. So we've completed the octets for the fluorine atoms. They all have 8 valence electrons. We've used all 24 of our valence electrons here. Boron, though, that only has 6 valence electrons around it, which isn't an octet. However, boron is an exception. So for boron, we only need 6 electrons around it for its outer shell to be full. So this is the correct Lewis structure for BF3. The boron doesn't have 8 valence electrons, but that's okay. It's an exception. It can do that. If we wanted to talk about the molecular geometry, we'd end up with a trigonal planar molecular geometry because each of these fluorines, they'd push away from each other and spread out. And that would look like this. So you can see how the fluorines are all in the same plane. If you need help with the molecular geometry for BF3, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Lewis structure for BF3, boron trifluoride. Thanks for watching.